Hello beautiful people, thank you for joining us again today. In today's video, I will show you how you can integrate CKEditor into your Angular project. In this video, I'll show you how to integrate CKEditor Classic from the official CKEditor documentation and website, and then I'll also show you how you can integrate CKEditor 4 with the full control. If you see the difference between CK Classic, it's not the full control, right? But you might need the full control. I'll also show you how you can integrate that in Angular project. And also, I'll also show you how you can validate. There is no official, as of this moment, how to validate this in Angular material, right? So I've had issues where I have to deal with the validation myself, just to ensure that when you submit this, it comes back with value, right? So if you see, so if I don't put in anything in this content area and I try to submit this form, it bounces back and tells me I need to add content to proceed. Okay, so I'll also show you how to do this validation. All right, so if today is your first time watching our videos, thank you so much, and please consider subscribing, hit the like button, leave us a comment, question, really appreciate that. Without further delays, let's get to it. If you're feeling generous, you can buy me a coffee, but subscribing, leaving a comment, and hitting the like button, any of those actions equals a cup of coffee to me. So thank you so much for taking those actions. So I have set up a new project. It's actually just plain. I just basically just have my header here, and then I have few input fields that you can just see here. It's just font fields, two of them, and then I have left a space for the CKEditor. Now, CKEditor is one of the WYSIWYG editors that you can use for your any project. This could be a form, or this could be content that you want to display, or you want to create like a post, right? You can use CKEditor, or you can also use another one called TinyNC. Now, there has been a long debate about which one is best, which one is better, and all that stuff, but again, it all boils down to you, what you want to use and what works for your particular requirement. So the choice is totally yours. The first step that I want to do is look at the documentation for CKEditor Classic. There is, if you go to the CKEditor documentation, you will see frameworks, you will see Angular component. That's what I want to look at. So the installation is pretty straightforward. I just need to install CKEditor Build Classic. So I just grab this command and then come to my Visual Studio Code and then run that command. This will install CKEditor Classic in my project. Okay, so I'm having this issue. There's a version conflict between now and when I'm doing the video. This is about some version difference. Now, I intentionally left this here so that in case you run into similar issues, you know how to fix it. So for me to fix this, I just run the same command, but I need to put in a different option, which is legacy pair depth immediately after the command that I need to run. So I just put a space. It will install that CKEditor for me. Just in case you have that error, you know how to fix it. Okay, so that's the first step. I go back to the documentation. So the next thing I need to do is to import the CKEditor into my app module. So I go to my app module and then I paste it here, and then I put it, load it in the import section. The next step, I need to import CKEditor into my component.ts file. So I go to home component.ts, and then I import CKEditor Classic. Next, I need to declare a variable and assign that to Classic Editor. So I need to create a variable and do a direct assignment to Classic Editor. So I just copy that line, and down here I just paste that. And I save and look at it. Then the next step is to grab this line of code, and then I'm going to paste this in my component.html file. We already have a space where we want to display CKEditor. I'm just going to paste it there. Alright, so if you're also experiencing issues after installing or adding to your app module, especially if the issue says something like it appears ng module import could not be resolved and stuff like that, just restart ng serve. Sometimes you get errors like ng module has not been processed correctly by ngcc. So I found that when I restart the server, it usually just works fine. Okay, so in case you have that issue, you try to do that, it will resolve it and you'll be back on track in no time. Cool. All right, so from my application here, I have added CKEditor module to my app module. The next thing is to add a CKEditor to the HTML file of my application. So if I go to the documentation again, I just need to grab this. Then I'm gonna paste it here. And when I save it, voila. So I have CKEditor, classic CKEditor. I can style it however I want. I can make it bold, paragraph, heading, and all that. But as you can see, there's no validation in it. Also, there are a few things I can do as well. If I like to have a different, like a placeholder text, I can do that. I just need to remove this one. So if you just want to integrate CKEditor at this point, you've virtually achieved your aim, so that's so good. But keep watching, because I'm going to show you some other configurations you can do with CKEditor and also the validation. So for example, if I want to put a placeholder in CKEditor, assuming this is a form, I can do that. So here in CKEditor, I just need to do configuration. That's a keyword, and by the way, this is also in the documentation somewhere. If you read through this documentation, you will also find it, so I'm not doing magic. And then I'm going to put it as placeholder. And I'm going to put what I want to be in the placeholder. So I need to wrap this. Okay, got to fix that. Right, so now I have placeholder text that will always be there when this page loads. Okay, so at this point, the next thing that I want to do is to actually validate this form, so that if I don't have input here, if I try to submit this form, it's gonna give me an error warning and it will not proceed. Okay, let's do that. So for us to validate this mod form field, the first thing that I need to do is to add form control to the input, and also if I'm going to validate it especially as required fields, then I need to use this word required in all the fields. All right, so what I need to do here is to add form control. Never mind about the error, this error is because I don't have I have not declared it anywhere in my component, so I'm gonna get to that. So I'm just gonna copy this just to make sure this video is not so long. In the component.ts file, I just need to declare title. Now, when you type this, it automatically import this validator from Angular forms. Faster. I'm going to change this to department. And then here we need to write a method that gets the error message. Alright, so I'm just going to duplicate this for the rest of the form field. can just grab the math error and then I'll tie it that to the component that here's called. Now if I go to angular material form field, I'm just gonna look for one with error. I think this one has got error. I'm just gonna grab the error message here. Put in any value in the title, I get this error message. So I'm just going to repeat that for the rest of the field and then let's see how it goes. But this will not solve the CKEditor issue because it's not an angular material component, right? So it's not going to solve that issue of the way this has just been fixed, which is why I'll show you that middle after this. So now with other angular material form fields, when you click and you go out and you don't put anything, it gives you this error only when you don't put in anything. But on page load, it's normal, it's okay, it doesn't show you any error message. The problem with CKEditor validation in Angular that I have seen is, so now this error message stays. So you now need to control this error message only when there's no content. So for me to do that, I need to add this to the function on the submit so that when I submit, it checks everything, every form field, and then triggers this error if there is no content in the CKEditor. All right, let's do that. Check CKEditor. This will be any and then equals false. So for this particular reason, I'm only gonna check because the other form fields are okay. I'm only gonna check if they have been touched or not, but I'm gonna validate CKEditor content only. So let's see that. So if this is not valid, and then I'm going to check for the rest form field and then mark them as touched. This and I'm going to create a click event, then it should run that function. Okay, let's see. So this is title, this should be department, and this should be content. Okay, let's go check again. So we need to also check that CKEditor has also been checked, so we're gonna do this. See that? All right. So now, if you don't enter any value or you don't have any content in the CKEditor, when you submit, you get this error and all the form fields are marked as checked. So it just checks to ensure there's an input. If there's an input, it flags that. So this is how you can validate CKEditor in your Angular project. The next thing that I want to show you is how you can integrate the CKEditor 4 with the full control. I'll also show you how you can integrate CKEditor 5, this full control, in CKEditor 5 Classic. All right, let's do that. Now, in order for me to do this, I need to look at this other documentation. So this is not officially from a CKEditor, but I've used it. So what we need to do, we need to run this npm install, and then we need to copy this script and put at the bottom before the closing tag of the body in HTML, which is here before the closing body tag. So, but first, let's install. Now you don't have to actually add this last option, the legacy pair depth, because I'm having different versions of the version conflict. That's why I'm doing that. You don't really need to. You just do npm I ng2 CKEditor. That should actually just work. And now that I've done this, so this is gonna conflict with the CKEditor class that I have. So I just need to disable that particular one. So for me to do that, first of all, let me just copy this. Put it here. When I put CKEditor 4 full with the full control, automatically my CKEditor 5 Classic picks this full control. That's not what I want to show you. Let's go see how I can integrate the full control with everything looking nice. So I go to app module and then I disable this one. I duplicate this one first and I disable one of it. This is going to come from an ng2 editor. Right, and then here in my CKEditor, I just want to disable this. Because it's different libraries, I need to get rid of all of this. And now when I save it, you can see CKEditor 4 with full control. So I can put anything here, and I can make it bold, italics, underline, full control. Also, I still have my validation. So if I don't put in anything, it's to validate. If you're enjoying this video so far, please leave us a thumbs up, leave us a comment, and please subscribe to this channel for more content like this. So at this point, we've been able to integrate CKEditor into Angular project, CKEditor Classic, and also CKEditor 4 with full control. If you're feeling generous, don't forget to buy me a coffee, or you can just subscribe. That means a cup of coffee for me. Thank you so much, and see you in the next one.